So today I'm going to review this beautiful Luxman set, and that is the power amplifier, the M383, let me zoom in, yes, and the preamplifier, the C383. And well, the thing is, I have this thing for, I think, 2 months now in my house, and all this time, because I paid €650 for the thing, all this time I thought, well, this is easy to sell, you know, I tried to sell it, you know, I had a bid from 600 at a certain moment, but this guy, when I told him, come on, pick it up, he didn't react. I had a bid from €450, same thing, the guy didn't show up, you know, and so finally, the buyer is coming in 40 minutes, and you won't believe it. I will sell this thing for €350, and that's a big loss, my friends. That means the thing came with I had a headphone when I was there. The guy told me, okay, you get from me a free headphone. So that was a surprise for me. And the headphone, I'm not sure what the value is, but yeah, it's not special, you know, second-hand headphone, maybe €25-50. I'm not sure. So that's the only positive thing on this deal, because it was an hour driving, so that means €40 gasoline, and that came above the €650. So I paid almost €700 for the thing, if you calculate the benzene, the gasoline money with it. And the buyer is going to pick this thing up for €350, and then you can think, okay, you have to wait a little bit longer. I know this. When I wait, you know, when I have the patient, I have a few months extra time. I maybe can sell it for the price I wanted, the €650. So I have my money back, €650, you know, €700, you know, because I didn't even calculate my gasoline money when I sell it. I even would lose money when I would sell it for €650, because then I lose my gasoline money. But yeah, I thought to buy this thing for myself, you know, to replace my Akai AM93. And because it's a power beast, you know, but in the Netherlands, you know, it's just, maybe in the rest of the world you can get 600, 700, 800, or 900 or dollar, but not in the Netherlands, my friends. And I learned it the hard way. So I lose, when this guy comes 40 minutes from now, I will lose €300. I will lose, you know, because the gasoline money, I don't calculate, because maybe when I sell this headphone, I have this €40 back. So I will lose €300, and that's, you know, I often lose 50, 100, you know, sometimes 150. Also, that is hard, you know, but this 300, well, my friends, sometimes I think, why I still making movies or videos, you know, if I lose so much, so much cash, you know, because it's a lot, for me, it's a lot of money, you know, not sure for you, but. And if you know, those dealers, they have 100 items, and they have patience, they have cash value, cash in the pocket, so they can wait, they don't have to sell it that quick. But I need this cash to buy new stuff, you know. And that's the negative thing from this set, that I lose so much money. And it's my fault, my mistake, you know, and I often make this mistake. It's not the first time, I do it all the time, but I never lose so much money, you know. 300 is a lot in one time, in one deal, you know. I don't cry for 50 or €100, but 300 is a lot. Anyway, this is how it is looking, you know. And beautiful, beautiful gold champagne. It's not gold, champagne color, you know. Only the power amp have a weight from 17.7 kilogram, you know. And it is, let me show you the inside first. Then you understand why this amplifier is so heavy. Well, this is the amplifier it opened, you know. And I wanted to show you this because this is, I never had a amplifier this big. And let me place a battery on top of this travo so you can see how big this travo really is. It is really I think 15 centimeter diagram. It is really a monster. And well, it is unbelievable how big this thing is. And the end filters, as you can see over here, four of them, yes, go on top of them. You see there are four of them. They are 90 volt, 15,000 microfarad each. So together we have 60,000 microfarad, you know. And these babies have to feed these power transistors over here, yes. In the corner, you can see one over here, yeah. And they are all in line, as you can see. And every channel, every side have eight of these sunken power transistors. So, no, six. So together you have 12 from these power transistors. And that's huge, my friends, that's huge. And that's why this thing can deliver 2 × 220 W/8 ohms, yes. And really, this thing is a beautiful, from the inside, a beautiful thing. If you need recapping, it is not that difficult as those older vintage models, because the wires you can just plug out, as you can see over here, also over here, you know, you don't have nothing to solder, and just take away this screw over here, the screw over here, the screw over here, and the screw over there for on the upper side. And of course you have to screw loose the power transistor, every power transistor one screw, so you have to screw 10 screws, you know, 6 from the power transistors and these 4, and the board come loose, and then you can recap the thing very easy. And also these are easy to recap. So well, this thing is from 1995, 1996. It doesn't really need a recap after 22 years, you know. It all depends how much the thing is used, how much it is clicked on and off every day, you know. But I don't see pop-up transistors. They're all looking pretty flat. So this thing, well, can last for at least 5 more years if you use it frequently. Maybe even 10 years before it needs a recap. I don't see any wrong transistor, no. But I see here, they are looking all fine. And I already test this thing a few times, and well, not a few times. It is spinning in my house for, well, for the last 1.5, 2 months. 2 months since I bought the thing, it is on my table spinning, you know. And I didn't put it over there because I was waiting for my Akai, you know. And over here, this is my cabinet. And my Akai is returned. It is returned. I have to place the wooden side blocks. But before I do that, I want to show you the inside of this Akai, what they serviced on this thing. I make a separate video from that Akai. So that's why I still didn't connect the wooden side blocks. Anyway. Well, this is how it is looking inside. You know, one more time from the top, so you can see how impressive this thing is, you know. And it is a Luxman, so not just an ordinary brand. Just this thing is a Luxman. And on the back side you see this. This you see on the back side. And of course you see here, you see the Luxman. It doesn't have a voltage switch. As you can see, it is only a 220 volt, 50 hertz. Yeah, of course, the speaker connections, yes, left and right. You can play, as you can read over here, A and B. You can play four speakers, no, two speakers, between from 4 ohm or 4 speakers together. From 8 ohms, but believe me, you can easily play 4 speakers from 4 ohm as long you don't use too much power, you know, not the maximum power, of course, but you don't need that maximum power. It's impossible to spin 220 watt in your house. This is a I'm not sure what it is, from preamp. This is a line phase sensor, also not sure what this thing is. And here we have a BTL operation, also that I don't know what it is, but it is on off, and it stays on off. These are the cables, but let me takeaway one. I bought this set with these cables, yeah, pure Sonic, and they are pretty good cables. I just watched these cables on the internet, and they are not cheap cables. Even second hand, they are expensive. Well, expensive, I think 50 euro for a pair, you know, pure Sonic cables, good thick cables, my friends. And because there is a difference, I test this amp with these cables over here, and the difference you hear the difference back when you play it without music. You hear a distortion with the thinner cables. If you have a power amplifier like this, never use these cables, you know, just use these thicker cables, you know. It is 220 watt, so don't think you can have a good sound with those thinner cables. Just use these thick cables, or, well, I have other thick cables like this, you know. You can use these cables. These are also very good cables, you know. And but use good cables for this thing. This is the pre-amplifier with all the connections. This is the phono, you know, turntable connection, only one. CD tuner, LD, AV, VCR, tape 2, tape 1, LD in, AV in, everything, all the connections this thing have. Repeater, I'm not sure what is a repeater, extreme sensor, bus line, you know, this is what it have. Of course, here you have the serial number, and a line phase sensor, not sure what it is, my friends. But anyway, I connected with these two cables. This is how I connected it. And this is how it is looking from the front side. This is how it is looking from the front side. And I'm filming with 4K now, yes. I already made this movie with normal HD. And then I noticed, oh my God, I filmed in HD. So I had to film this video all over again in 4K, because lately I prefer filming and uploading in 4K for the, well, the sharper image you have, you know, a little bit sharper. If you watch this video on your tablet or on your phone, you won't see the difference between 4K and HD, but when you watch it on your television, you see, of course, the difference very fast, you know. And this is what the front side is from the pre-amplifier, you know. It have, of course, this is the record out selector with all the connections, bass, treble are placed on flat, as you can see. Continuous play, not sure what it is. Remote sensor, this thing have a remote sensor. This is the remote sensor, you know, and simple thing. And here we have the balance, loudness, what I don't use anymore. This thing doesn't have a MM or MC switch for your turntable, and that's a big miss, I think, for a lot of people who are still using their turntable. These are the other connections over here. Beautiful, beautiful layout, but it misses the MM or MC switch, so you can... Well, you can switch between MM or MC elements from your turntable. And beautiful, shiny. It is a little bit dirty, you know. It's not clean. This is how it goes on. You know, just like here. And I'm going to show you when I place this thing on zero. This thing is already... Yeah, it's on now. Click, you heard it. Click, click, click. The thing use 36 watt on power. 44. And it goes, it walks up, I believe, until 90 watt. I will show you that later in the video, you know, when the thing is spinning a few minutes. And well, let's start with a sound test. So, and this is how it sounds. And of course, here you have the left power and the right power. I put them both on half, so if I place this thing on maximum, this is the maximum, yeah, then I can only use a little bit from this volume knob, you know. And So it's on half now, and with my 4-ohm speakers, this thing puts out 2 × 340 W or 350 W by 4 ohms. This is an incredible amplifier, my friends. And this is how it sounds.
Thank you.
And of course, today I am using, like most of the times, my Canton Ergo RCLs, the brown big speakers, the floor standers, yes. Honest, to be 100% honest with you, the reason why I sell this combination is because the sound is not very nice, you know. It is too flat, you know, it is flat, it is not dirty, you know, it's a clean sound, but it's just too flat. I don't enjoy this amplifier, the sound of this amplifier, because the plan was, you know, maybe this thing can replace my Akai, because it is a Luxman, you know, and if you asked 10 persons, just, you know, random audiophiles, and you would ask them, what do you prefer, a Luxman or Akai? 9 out of 10, I almost believe 10 out of 10 would say, or would answer, well, a Luxman, because Luxman have the name. But it cannot compete with my Akai AM93. The looks are there. I prefer the looks above my Akai. That's one thing what is sure, but yeah. You know, you also want a good sound, and this thing, it just don't have that sound what I like. And that's the reason why I'm selling it, and because I would not have take that €300 loss, you know. But yeah, most of the things I buy, you know, because I always keep the best, you know, this is me. That's why I cannot take distance from that Still cannot take distance from that Sansui over there, that big Sansui, you know. I know I have to sell it one of these days. I have it now for 3 years. I have to sell it because, it is too big. It doesn't fit in that cabinet over there. The thing is too wide. And this thing would fit, but the sound isn't what I like. So, if you ask me sound-wise what it is worth, I would say, well, the 300-350 euro, what I will get in a few minutes from now, it's okay price, you know, not more than 350 euro. So I paid too much, but yeah, this is life. So this was the review. I hope you like it. And if you have this set and you don't agree with me that the sound is okay and you think the sound is good, well, that's up to you, you know. I just say what I think. Maybe the combination from this amplifier with the speakers is not the good combination. That can be the case, but yeah, I just don't like the sound, you know, in this combination. So thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up if you like this video, and for now I say bye bye.